Hi, I'm Siena. I'm gonna show you some color tips using adjustment layers and clipping masks. So if you see here, we have a very simple four-layer Photoshop drawing. We've got some hills and we've got a sky. And if you also notice, all the colors are very basic cartoony colors, not really much going on to them. So if we wanted to change the blue sky to more of a sunset, we could click the sky and then we could click the new layer button, which then creates a new layer. And if we right-click on that layer, and we go to Create Clipping Mask, that will then attach that layer to the layer underneath it. And whatever you do on the clipped layer, it will only show up on the layer that it is connected to. So now we draw a gradient, and now we have this yellow, nice sunset sky. Because we just changed the time of day, the hills, their color would also reflect that. So if we hold down Shift, and we click on the last hill, and we go back down here next to the new layer button, there's a new group button. So if you click that, it will put in all the selected layers into their own group. So if we go up top, click layer, and we scroll down to new adjustment layer, you're gonna see a lot of options. They're all pretty good. The ones I use the most are hue and saturation, color balance, curves, any of these will work. I'm gonna use color balance. That's gonna make a new color balance layer. And if we just go ahead and start moving the sliders around, you'll notice that it affects everything and not just the hills like you want it to. That's because both the sky and the hills are underneath this adjustment layer, and adjustment layers will affect anything underneath it. So if you want to isolate it to just one thing, like the hills, for example, you right-click on the adjustment layer. We can also make that a clipping mask. So now it'll be clipped to the group underneath it and only that. So it will only affect these hills, and then you can make them match whatever like tonal color you've got going on in the sky. That's how these work, and I hope that these were as helpful to you as they were to me when I first learned about them a few years back. These can be like really powerful tools to speed up your process from flatting to a final image.